Chapter 7, Particulate Nature of Matter, Question Answers, from Grade 8, Subject Science, Book Curiosity. Probe and Ponder, Question 1, why is it possible to pile up stones or sand, but not a liquid like water? Answer, stones and sand are solids, their particles are tightly packed and held by strong forces, so they have a fixed shape. This allows them to be piled up one over the other. Water is a liquid. Its particles are loosely packed and can move around freely. Liquids have no fixed shape and take the shape of the container, so they cannot be piled up like solids. Question 2. Why does water take the shape of folded hands but lose that shape when released? Answer. Liquids have no fixed shape but definite volume. When held in folded hands, the water adjusts to the space available and takes that shape. Once released, water flows freely due to weaker particle attractions and spreads, losing the hand's shape. Question 3. We cannot see air, so how does it add weight to an inflated balloon? Answer. Air is made of particles that have mass. When a balloon is inflated, these air particles get trapped inside it. The combined mass of these particles adds to the weight of the balloon, even though we cannot see them. Question 4. Is the air we breathe today the same that existed thousands of years ago? Answer. Yes. The air we breathe is made up of the same constituent particles, nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, etc., that have always existed. These particles keep cycling through nature. Respiration, photosynthesis, volcanic eruptions, etc. But the total amount of air on Earth remains almost the same. Thus, the air we breathe today is essentially the same as the air that existed thousands of years ago. Next, keep the curiosity alive. Question 1. Choose the correct option. The primary difference between solids and liquids is that the constituent particles are, answer 4th, closely packed in solids and move past each other in liquids. Question 2. Which of the following statements are true? Correct the false statements. First, melting ice into water is an example of the transformation of a solid into a liquid. So friends, this is true. Second, melting process involves a decrease in interparticle attractions during the transformation. Answer, true. Third, solids have a fixed shape and a fixed volume. Answer, true. Fourth, the interparticle interactions in solids are very strong and the interparticle spaces are very small. So friends, this is also true. Question 5th, when we heat camphor in one corner of a room, the fragrance reaches all corners of the room. Answer, true. 6th, on heating, we are adding energy to the camphor and the energy is released as a smell. So friends, this is false. Correction. On heating, camphor particles gain energy, escape into the air and diffuse. This allows its smell to spread, not because energy is released as smell. Question 3. Choose the correct answer with justification. If we could remove all the constituent particles from a chair, what would happen? Answer. 3rd. Nothing of the chair will remain. Reason, matter is made of particles. If particles are removed, no matter is left. Question 4. Why do gases mix easily while solids do not? Answer. In gases, particles are far apart and move freely at high speed, so they mix quickly, diffusion. In solids, particles are tightly packed with very little movement, so they cannot mix on their own. Question 5. When spilled on the table, milk in a glass tumbler flows and spreads out, but the glass tumbler stays in the same shape. Justify this statement. Answer. Milk is a liquid, no fixed shape, flows and spreads, but has a fixed volume. Glass tumbler is a solid, has both fixed shape and fixed volume. Question 6. Represent diagrammatically the changes in the arrangement of particles as ice melts and transforms into water vapor. Diagram, conceptual representation. Solid, ice, particles closely packed in order like this one. liquid water, particles close but move past each other less orderly. This one, gas, water vapor, particles far apart, move freely in all directions. This one. So friends, this is the figure for solid, this is liquid and this is gas. Question 7. Draw a picture representing particles present in the following. First, aluminium foil solid, this one. Second, glycerin liquid, this one. Third, methane gas, this one. So friends, you can draw these pictures for solid, liquid and gas. Question 8. Observe figure 7.16a, which shows the image of a candle that was just extinguished after burning for some time. Identify the different states of wax in the figure and match them with figure 7.16b, showing the arrangement of particles. So friends, this is gas. So this is represented by this gas. This is liquid. So this is represented by this figure. And this is solid, so this is represented by this figure. Question 9. Why does the water in the ocean taste salty even though the salt is not visible? Explain. Answer. Ocean water contains dissolved salts like sodium chloride. Salt particles break into tiny ions and occupy spaces between water particles. They are invisible to the eye but make the water taste salty. Question 10. Grains of rice and rice flour take the shape of the container when placed in different jars. Are they solids or liquids? Explain. Answer. Both rice grains and rice flour are solids. Each grain or particle has a fixed shape. They only appear to take the shape of the container because the grains are small and separate, but individually they remain solids. Next, discover design and debate. So friends, if you need answers of these questions too, just write a comment in the comment box. I will provide these question answers on my website. So friends, we have completed question answers of chapter 7, Particulate Nature of Matter. We have already studied the notes and summary of this chapter. You can find the link in the description and on the screen. If you like the video, kindly like, hype the video and share it with your friends. Also subscribe to my channel for more such videos. We will meet in the next video. Thank you for watching.